just last week, Dame Helen Mirren claimed that sex is by no means the key to a long-lasting and happy relationship.
Well, one woman who disagrees with Dame Helen is single mum Kelly Rose Bradford. Kelly believes sex is the most important factor in a relationship, and she even goes as far to say that if her partner lost his sex drive, she would leave him.
Then there's mum of four, Shona... is it Sybury?
Sybury.
Yes, Sybury, who says her and her husband can go months without sex, and they're in fact happier than ever. So who is right?
If you want to get involved in this debate, you can go to our website, itv.com/thismorning, to tell us who you signed with using our interactive web. Welcome to both of you. Now, Shona, let's start with you first of all. You're a mother of four, aren't you?
I am.
So how important is sex in your marriage? How long have you been married for?
13 years.
13
this
years.
This is our 14th. Yeah, we'll have our 14th wedding anniversary.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how important is sex in your relationship?
Well, I think the important thing to remember is that sex is a long old road. Well, no, not sex, marriage is a long old road. And, you know, sex within marriage is going to go up and down and ebb and flow. And I think that we're the only generation that have become so hooked on this idea that sex within a marriage is the most crucial aspect. Historically, marriage worked as a structure and a framework within society in which to support a growing family. And I think once you've made a commitment to somebody and you've got your head around the fact that you're in it for the long run, you know, you're going to accept that there will be changes in the dynamics within that due to the pressures in everybody's lives, which are different depending on who you are and what your life is.
Well, you're married, you both work, and you're a mum of four. You've got a 14-year-old, a 12-year-old, 10-year-old and a 3-year-old.
Well done, by
the way. Busy life. We're here to talk quite frankly, so I will ask you, what is acceptable for you? How many times a week, a month, a day?
Well, I will answer that question, but I think that's the problem with the whole issue. I think it's really unhelpful to focus on numbers, and I just think everybody's become really sort of strung out on this idea that, you know, you have to have sex a certain amount of times to make a marriage work. And I think there are, you know, women at home at the moment watching this who are going to be worrying about how often they have sex. And I think this, you know, the whole debate around it puts pressure on women, and we're already under enough pressure. Everybody knows being a mother and a working mother, there are so many demands on your time and your energy. And to talk about, you know, it's like breastfeeding and dieting and all these other things that are thrown at you just to make
it
you feel guilty.
Though, maybe I can just interrupt you. It's nothing to do with that, because you're kind of saying it's almost like another thing you need to tick off the to-do list. And I know that you actually, when you wrote about this, you said you'd rather mop the floor than have sex with your husband, which is kind of, you know, the floor can wait, surely. Sure, you must want to have that physical relationship with your husband, because if you'd rather mop the floor, that would suggest that, you know, you're not sexually attracted
I would
to him.
Rather
you,
mop
you
the floor.
You don't want to be with him.
Because the floor needs mopping, and there's
but
a
the
list
floor
of priorities.
Can wait, you know, but
I still haven't taken my Christmas decorations down yet. You know, there is
but we can always
so
make
many
excuses.
Things to do.
We can always make excuses, and I think the whole busy thing is something we generally use when we want to get out of doing something. I'm not denying, you know, we're both working mums. I appreciate know how busy you are, but I think, you know, we do tend to use this, oh, I'm so busy thing, when we don't particularly want to do something. And I kind of, you know, I don't
That's
want to
not
put your
excuse.
Sex life or your relationship under
because,
scrutiny.
Not
I'm
just
not criticising, but I kind of think it's very, very sad that you're in a situation where you can't make that sort of like time for you and your husband a priority.
Is
yet
it sad,
the
is it sad is? Because you're very happy in your marriage? I mean, you and your partner are very happy. I mean, is it sad? Are we meant to look at her and pity her? She's coming
I don't
here
think
that her life is fine. She's happy.
I don't think it is sad, and I think it's very dangerous to send out the signal to people getting married that your sex life has got to stay at the same level throughout your marriage. As I said before, it's a long old road, and I think if you speak to people, and I've interviewed couples that have been married for 50, 60 years, they will say to you that there were periods during their marriage where their sex life
well,
did